Stefan's 50 years older than me, and from another country, so his first language is different to mine. But those things don't matter in music. Musicians that have worked with Stefan over the years have been people that he likes, as he likes them as people. He likes the way they play, so he's not asking you to play like somebody else. He liked the way I play. He just wanted me to play that way.
At last, I can get you.
He's just arrived from the airport a few hours ago, so he feels pretty tired, so he's had a rest, so I'm just walking around to see him now. He just phoned to say that he's well. I mean, it's amazing, 85 years of age, and he's still traveling all around the world. I know I get tired traveling all the time, so he's an amazing character, he really is. He finishes the gig and has his glass of milk, goes to bed, you know. So he takes very good care of himself. He doesn't go to discotheques after the gig or anything like that. I think he's got past that stage in life. How are you? You like that hat? I've got a very big head though, Stefan. Let's see. Here.
Oh, yeah.
Olé! I'm going to start with the piano. I start my musical life to play the piano because in those days, jazz was not known in France. I remember in 1923 when I went to play to a silent picture. Nobody knew about jazz. The record came in Paris later on. But the first record I heard, I decided it will be my music.
Stefan's repertoire really comes out of the classic jazz repertoire, Gershwin's, Cole Porter, Jerome Kern. He really has he just put his stamp on that music. So whatever Stefan plays, he always puts on this stamp that says Stefan Grappelli. Over there. You know what James has been doing, Stefan? He's been busking.
What does he mean?
He's been busking. You know,
busking?
Playing the street.
Playing in the streets.
Mm. I did it once.
You did that?
Of course. I know all the good address.
Yeah.
There you are, Stefan knows all the good spots in Paris to go busking.
Place d'Anvers.
Is that where you used to bus?
No. A bit better everywhere. In the courtyard.
Oh, yeah?
Because in those days you can do it. Now they don't. Because the people's got radio, television, they don't open the window anymore.
Oh, you used to play underneath the window?
No, it was nothing when we were doing that, playing in the court.
Did Django busk as well, then?
He did, with his brother.
Yeah, with Joseph.
And I did a little bit with him.
Yeah.
Then for 2-3 years I didn't see him.
But he didn't like it, did he?
But he was a bit like that, he liked the money there, you know.
Stefan and Django, they formed this group that was really the first acoustic jazz group. And in fact, when they first started playing, it was quite alien to a lot of people. Stefan told me that they'd be playing in places and people would be dancing by and they'd start playing and they'd start putting their fingers in their ears because they'd never heard anything like it.
And I was playing with 18, 19. I was well in the profession then in those times. I was playing for dancing, evening party and all that. So I was playing with, or sometimes a pianist, Army, to play with him. But the guitar came later. When I was about 20, I met Django Reinhardt. And all the story with guitar came Arab from that time.
Well, the first records I ever heard were of the Hot Club. And that's why I started to play guitar, because my dad used to play Hot Club records all the time. So I grew up, the first sounds I ever heard were Django and Stefan playing.
We meet in the rendezvous. Place Pigalle. It was a rendezvous of musicians.
Yeah. When would that have been? What year?
Oh, must be, 1 minute. Oh. I was going to the silent picture. So it was in 1922.
They were the first European musicians to play jazz in a European style. Before that, European jazz musicians were really mimicking Americans, and they came up with their own voice, something that was purely European jazz.
Fishing, you like to fish, yeah. So you can fish in Paris in the Place Pigalle in the bassin there.
What was it? Actually, you told me a story about him, about Django fishing, and he used to just get a twig from a tree and a piece of line and a nail.
He'd get fish like that. And next to him, it was two old men with the latest
Nothing at all?
Nothing. They were mad with him.
Stefan and Django formed the group, which was three guitars, violin and bass. No drums or saxes. They could play as a unit, balanced within themselves because of no mics. And Django just developed this way of playing, this really strong right-hand technique, and playing nearer the bridge so that it had a more cutting sound, and it would really kind of pierce through. You'd get more sound more like this. Grew up listening to guitar, and it's something that I wanted to do from very early on. And I started playing because I loved the music, I loved the instrument. And unlike some people who take it up because they seek stardom, I've never looked for that. My quest is to become better and better on the guitar, to learn all the time. Thank you.
pense que de toute façon Martine vient te chercher.
Hello Martine.
How are you?
Oh, Martine.
How are you? Want a hand?
Yes.
There you go.
You need to move that foot. You know what I mean, man.
All right. There we go.
Tell her, say what. What are you going to think about me?
When my father came back from the army in 1918, I don't know for which reason, I still don't know why he gave me a violin. He disappeared, and it's too late to ask him. But he gave me a small violin. We can get that somewhere. Maybe to amuse me, maybe to amuse him, I don't know. So I start, because since I was a child, I always like music, to hear music.
Aristocrat? You sound like the name.
Well, I don't know if she was, but she was a marvelous lady, I think. That's why we did that. Daphne, where she's gone, I don't know.
A lot of things came late to Stefan, really. It wasn't really until the early 70s, that there was a resurgence for Stefan. I mean, he'd always been a very popular, very, very famous figure in jazz, but in the 70s, Stefan began to play more with guitar again. And I think the fact that he went from playing with piano trios to playing with guitarists again sparked something in people's imagination, took them back to the days of the Hot Club.
And in 1973, we were invited to do the pub festival in Cambridge. Apparently, I was told it was 25,000 young people. And I said, maybe they will think I'm too old for them. I didn't expect much, you see. So I decided to stay with the guitar. So came along Martin Taylor. Then, of course, I must admit, I said, my God, it's not Django Reinhardt, but it's Martin Taylor. It's something. Thank you.
knowing the way he approaches music, the way he plays, I've always tried to really bring that out with him, and sometimes throw him something that then makes him go, oh, what's that? And it sparks something for him, and then he plays something that he hasn't played before. And then he gives me one of those little impish looks and says, what did you do there?
You can't learn jazz. I remember Louis Armstrong used to say, if you don't get it, you will never get it.
Stefan hasn't had a classical training, but he has a great love for classical music. So I think that he's really brought that sound, that discipline from classical music, along with the other discipline, which is jazz improvisation. So he's brought this magical blend together, and it's nobody else does it. But Stefan only has to play one note, you know it's him, and that's the sign of a great musician.
Improvisation must be like a classical, like Bach. The best must be respected. You can't go to a chord to another stupidly. There is a success section, and that's why we understand and we can play together. You see, today we play together, we didn't rehearse, and we play the tune because there is a communion between us. Thank you.
how can I say, he's just got better. I don't know. It amazes all of us. Everybody that I know, the people that we've known him for a long time, we just look at him and say, he's playing better and better. What's, you know, how does he do it?
I tell you everything. I told you everything. I like to go to the end to play. One day, maybe my ball will drop. But I can, the people which have tell me, I play music to the end.